For the latest top tips, reviews and advice, please subscribe below.
Hello and welcome to Attwoolls Outdoors with me, Mike. Today I'm giving you a bit of a review on a new tent from Opus. So with me here today, I've got the Opus Smart Tent T24. Now, Opus is a brand, but if you've not heard them before, they're definitely more renowned in kind of making trailer tents. But what they've done is launched a new tent range for the 24-25 season. And the T24 is the smallest one they do. They do one a bit bigger as well, which is the T48. And we've got a separate video talking through all the features of that. So one thing that really makes this difference is the fact they've used the name, basically the term smart tent. Now, what this actually relates to is the fact these are kind of the first kind of really self-inflating tents. There's no pumping involved from physically yourself. There's a built-in pump into the actual tent itself where you press a button, it does all the work for you. So that's really kind of the main headline of USP of this particular range. You ask me how? It's a very clever little system. What you have is almost little battery packs located in sort of which you can obviously pop in, and that's rechargeable, and that will actually pump and power the pump that then pumps the tent itself. We have something like the T24, we've got two pumps, i.e. two battery packs, that will pump up this tent. And again, you can see from our own kind of Attwoolls pitching packing video on this product, how quick, simple and easy it really is. And I quite literally sit there in a chair, let it do its pumping, and then peg it out. So definitely the most strenuous part of pitching tents and air tents especially is the pumping. And that's where Opus have took that away from you. So it's a really nice little concept, something I'm certainly will carry on, but being the first, and to be fair, they've done it in a really thought out way and they've took their time with it as well. So that's certainly the thing probably is definitely most impressive about this model itself. Now, the T24 is more orientated to be sort of a 2 or 4 person tent. So you've almost got kind of 3 zones to the tent itself. You've got your sleeping area, you know, a smallish living area, and then obviously a canopy as well. As you see it pitched here, I've actually got it with an optional front door. We've kind of bundled it in with a price that we're selling it for anyway, along with, say, a footprint as well, which comes as standard with the tent. You've also got a roof cover. So it's a really nice kind of package. Admittedly, because of the technology in it and the specification of the tent, it's not the cheapest. But if you're looking for something that's really good quality, obviously the whole self-inflating side of things, and you know, all about the features, then it does tick a lot of boxes. Now, what Opus has done is they've used a really nice rugged 300D fabric. So it's a really nice strong fabric, waterproof to 6,000 mil hydrostatic head. So again, great waterproofness and a great, obviously, durability as well. The joys of having a built-on roof cover is the fact almost you've got this double glazing kind of effect. So it helps create a little pocket of air between the layers, not only to sort of help reduce the temperature internally or increase it on colder weathers, but also in terms of the sunlight and UV, it takes the brunt of that. So that makes life a lot simpler. You always leave it on. There's no need to take it off or on. It works quite simply, and it gives you an opportunity to have a real nice touch and feel of the fabric itself. It's a small tent in terms of overall size. So the overall width for it is 305 centimeters and then 168 centimeters long. So small kind of size. In terms of, because of the high specification, it is a little bit on the weightier side. So you're looking around about 42 kilograms for the tent itself, but that's including everything you pretty much see as you see it here. You get a roller bag comes as standard with it. So again, really nice and oversized. But because obviously the sheer size of the tent is probably a bit more of a lump, and with the fact that it weighs a bit more, you've got carry handles at either side, roller wheels to sort of go across even grassy terrain. The other thing I do really like is actually got storage pockets built into the bag. So it's a perfect place to store your batteries. So it means you can keep everything quite nice and neatly in there. The batteries don't just pump the tent up, but once you've pumped the tent up, you can then remove them like I have here. And then what you can more than happily do is then use that as a battery pack within the tent. So you can run lights, you can charge your phones off it. So it's a really quite almost complete system, if you don't mind me, that actually works really nicely. So on the actual battery pack itself, there is a clear kind of out input and in. So whether you're charging it or putting it out, each battery is basically 3000 milliamps. So it's a really nice, strong, powerful battery. It will do the tent, I'm pretty sure, for single charge. I think it's about at least 3 to 4 times. But then of course you can recharge these anyway. And running off the lights, I think it's something mad like it does anywhere between 12 to 15 hours off the Opus official lights as well. which you're only going to have on maybe an hour or two at night. So again, especially once it's put the tent up, it then gives you lighting. So it's a tent that kind of keeps on giving in that sense. The optional front door, as you see it here, just zips on and off. You've got, if I just get this out of the way, it zips on all the way around, so it really feels like part of the tent. But obviously you can have the option to completely remove it if you don't want to. You've got a really nice big PVC window located in the front. Actually, the PVC material is really nice. Again, it's all about fit and durability is the key kind of DNA within the tent itself. The zips are oversized as well, so it really helps to create that kind of robust feel. So that's, you've got a little bit of a mini door located at the front there, so you can actually roll that back, and then that'll be your entrance in. Located on the side of here as well is an additional zip that allows you to zip on Opus's windbreaks. You can add additionally to it. So that's something, again, we should see in the marketplace fairly shortly, but you've got the capacity to do that. So they have really kind of tried to future-proof the whole design itself. We've got high visibility webbing straps around the whole tent. There's a little bit of flint in there as well, so when you've got a torch and stuff, it reflects back so you can quite clearly see where you're going to. You've got some pegs included as standard. I've used my own just for pitching it itself. But again, you've got two of these batteries supplied with it as standard as well. You can buy additional ones if you wanted to and kind of swap and change them. You also get a charging unit for these as well. So again, everything you pretty much need to get yourself off the marks, you get to have quite happily. Now, what we'll do, let me take this front panel out, so we can probably see, where is my zip, how it works in comparison. So you can see kind of the other setup, you can have it as, almost as it would be in the standard tent itself. There we go. And again, for sort of reducing the weight, of course you can sort of store that separately and pack that away separately, but for the time being I'm just gonna lay it over there. So now this is kind of how you would typically tend to see it without the kind of the front door panel. So you've got a really nice open canopy. Now, one thing you can almost have, because you've got a roof section up here, is obviously giving you protection from the UV, but the side doors on either side can also be put up with some additional canopy poles that you can buy extra, and that will just then increase your overall sort of space. So you've got eyelets built into the side here. You can buy some additional king poles, obviously zip the curtains up, and that increases the size of that as well. In all of the side panels, you've got windows, so you can get your privacy when you want to. And the thing that's quite impressive actually really is how, when you do zip the windows up, certainly for sort of a night time, is how dark it can be with inside the tent. Again, if you just wanted to cover an open canopy, you have the option to roll this up. So again, it just kind of increases your view if you don't want to sort of the window. But because you've got the option of it on both sides, you can pretty much pick and choose where you want it to. And again, if you have the front panel in place, you can more than happily use this as like an entrance side door, which if the wind was blowing from the other side, again, it's helpful that you sort of, you're not blowing into the wind in the tent with you. So that works really quite nicely as well. One thing we've got located around the back as well is a really nice big vent, which we'll come back to later on in the video. The bottom has big webbing straps, again, gives you great tension point, and then you've got elasticated points that then peg at the top of it. So the ground sheet can be pegged and adjusted properly, and then also the webbing, so the elasticated points can then pull that through. So that means when you have water comes off, it drains off and away from the tent and pushes it away from the footprint that comes included as standard. Now, each individual tube has its own inflation point. So if you do want to use it manually, you can do. So if for some reason you run out of battery for any reason, or you're touring, for example, you can use it manually as well. But the inflation point is also gonna be a deflation point as well. You've got a normal sort of Boston valve, so you can do that per se. And you can probably see there's sort of two zones located here as well. So the top one is basically for the battery. That merely just pops in like so. That one there. And what you've got is an off and on button. So you press that, and you can probably hear that little grumble. That's how quiet the pump is. So that's one of the best things about it, actually, in the way is that it's a very silent system. It's a small, like a slight humming noise. And more importantly, when it gets up to the pressure, it cuts off. So you haven't got to worry about what pressure's in the tent itself. No different to, there you go. No different to any other tent. Obviously, it's tested quite extensively. And some Opus have been done in their inflatable structure for a long time now. And unlike a lot of other tents as well, it has built-in ridge beams that goes from so. So there's only really two inflation points, should we say, which is the front section and the back section. So two beams are done in one. The T40, i.e. the bigger version of this tent, is a little bit different. But I'll tell you what, let's kind of swing the camera around. Let's go into the tent and talk through a load more features that has to offer. So now we're kind of in more in the front section. You can probably get a bit more of a better understanding for the tent itself. You've got this almost like canopy area at the front here. So this will be your sort of wet dry area. Happy to maybe cook underneath, or you've got some shelter. And again, with the flexibility of the doors, you can quite happily do what you need to as well. In the front section, you've got curtains. So even though you've got side panels, for example, you can get the option of privacy or your lovely clear PVC window to get a view out. So again, you can pretty much pick and choose what you want to. You want a little bit of view, but you don't want to keep the dogs from looking out. Then of course you can go kind of halfway with it. So you really kind of make it what you want it to. As we come into the sort of the living area or the main sort of sealed area, we've got a drop down door. So the door drops down, means you've got push chairs or wheelchairs accessibility more than happily into here. And when you want to obviously get sealed, it then sort of toggles up. So it doesn't zip at the bottom, but toggles. The side doors on the other hand, that has a full on zip. So that's got your fly mesh built into it as well. The front door, as we can see here, you've got almost like a half and half in terms of the window panels on the side. So you've got your sort of window, PVC window, then you've got your mesh above it. So again, you can bring that privacy curtain up, allow airflow, but still obviously get the length of privacy here. The front door has two. You've got a normal kind of blank door and a full frontal mesh door. So again, for airflow on a warm day, that's the one you're going to zip up, allow air to pass through it, make it feel a lot cooler in here. That's one thing I do notice on a warm day like it is today. It's not your typical kind of polyester kind of hotness in here. I think that's partly due to the fabric and that roofline really working well. With the air system you've got inside of here as well, even though each beam's done, each pair of beams are done continuously, you've got internal bracer beams in the roof section. That helps to make the tent pitch perfectly nearly every single time and gives it extra bit more structure in the tent itself. They're all interconnected and they've got isolation taps up here as well. So if you, God forbid, had an issue, you can literally just twist that. It segregates it from the rest of the tent itself. You can just repair it like a bike tire. So remove it, patch it, replace it, repair it, whatever you need to do, pop it back in and you're good to go. And it's been designed up, it's just kind of almost like garden hose kind of fittings. Something simpler and familiar we're all used to really. So that works really nicely. And merely probably the living space here is a bit tight, you know, for a table and chairs, and you're gonna probably pretty much use your space. But if you utilize this for a weekend tent or for ideally probably a couple's tent, that's where I think it personally works best. Inside here, as we look sort of left and right, we've got a, what they call it, like a 3-in-1 door position. So it's a window slash, so you can basically have the option between having visibility, breathability, or just the, or essentially privacy. So it's quite a nice little neat system. So currently you've got a zip curtain, as we kind of already suggested. So that can obviously go down. What you can then do is there is then a mesh panel that goes down. So you can have airflow directly into the tent without having to, you know, the bugs and everything else coming in, especially at night, that's a great thing. Or of course, if you really wanted to, you could put the, leave the mesh open and just put the privacy curtain up. You're not gonna get that much air directly come through it, but it's kind of gonna be there or thereabouts. But what I might do, and it all just kind of neatly rolls away into almost like a self-contained pocket at the bottom. Now beneath this window on the side here, there is also a little gusset. So even if you want obviously complete privacy, you can still get airflow directly underneath that as well. So that works really nicely. At the back, we've got some really nice dark bedrooms. They're called the sleep tight, so they're not blackout, but if I'm being honest, when you zip yourself in there, they are pretty damn dark. Really, because it's a sort of 305 width, you can actually fit a double air bed more than happily in both of them. So it is a true four-person tent. On the front of the actual bedroom inner, you do have a mesh panel as well. So what you do find on some cheaper models, let me get the right one. Often they will actually just have no particular mesh built onto it, but also the material they've used for the bedrooms is really quite nice. It's a bit more of a kind of like a kind of canvasy material, so that works really quite nicely as well. You've got adjustable straps that works, so if you get the play and get that bedroom looking really nice and taut. Also got storage pockets built into them as well, so you can obviously declutter the main part of the tent. Other things to mention obviously is the batteries. So there are little pockets located very secretly in kind of the sleeves, which will allow you to house your additional battery in there, so you can run the cable directly into that, up through the sleeve internally, and then lo and behold, which will, on the bottom there, you've got these very clever little pockets that will take kind of Opus's own lights. So that way you can have lighting coming into the tent itself, oops, Daisy, without having to worry about cables or powering it, nor hitting your head on it. So they have really kind of thought about it quite carefully when it comes to that. And also, like I said, having those beams in the roof section, you've got the structure and the means to get the lighting directly in. If you want more conventional lighting, you have got a hanging point for a lantern here and little Velcro tabs running down to cable entry points, which are located on the right hand side down there and same on the left, so just behind the bedrooms either side. In fact, let's bring the camera inside and probably get a bit more of a up close and personal with some of the details of the tent itself. Appreciate it's probably a little bit dark in there in comparison. So as we kind of come inside of here, you can see obviously with the different configuration we've got on the side doors. As we sort of step directly in, we've got the darker in, as I've just done one of those up for time being. Decent sort of depth, little storage pockets located down the bottom here as well, but like the materials look quite nice. There's an additional ventilation point at the back here as well. So again, you can alter the ventilation. You've got a divider that is actually between the two sections. It's zipped along the bottom, at the back, but not necessarily along the bottom. So it is a bit, so it's divided to a certain point, and even then you've got a little storage pocket built in there. Of course, what you could do is actually zip that directly up and have that as one big open bedroom if you wanted to. And again, I think if you're in more of a couple, then that's how you're really gonna run this tent. Little cable entry points located down the bottom here, so you can see one there, and the same on the other side. But there's a good sort of tolerance around the bedroom as well, so you're not having any worries about the inner touching the outer. That's the hanging point I was mentioning earlier. And what I said, if we take one of these zips down, located there is a lovely little pocket that basically will, like I said, house that little battery storage part to go in there quite nice and neatly. So that way it kind of keeps it all a bit seamless. You've got, so the door to this right hand side as we look at it now is just purely mesh, so it's not actually a door itself, whereas the door here is a general actual door that works really quite nicely. So again, if you really wanted to, you could actually bring that out and make a little canopy of it. So you almost have a canopy on the left and the right. But I think for me, it's just looking how well it sits. You know, you look at it, it looks smart. The colors and the trim looks really quite nice. But a whole, it's a good looking bit of kit and very practical. Obviously, it's very hard wearing. You've got the unique point of the fact that obviously it is self-inflating from that point of view. But all in all, I think it's a bit of a winner. The only thing I obviously, like I said, to bear in mind is purely down to the weight. You know, about 42 kilograms for a four-person tent. It is kind of weighty from that point of view, but the benefits of pitching it works well. Yeah, you've got a lot going for it, really. So it's quite an exciting tent and something nice to see some new technology in kind of the tent market. But any more questions or queries, of course, feel free to contact us directly at Attwoolls. You're welcome to comment in the box below what you think. We always love to have feedback from you guys. But really, that is kind of the Opus T24. Check out our pitching video we've done on this, as well as our video on the T40. But really, and all that's kind of our Attwoolls video review on the brand new Opus self-inflating tent. Hope to see you again in the next Attwoolls Outdoors video.